Welcome to Jaypree Cloud. Today's session, introduction to Amazon EC2 instance. You can launch a Linux instance using the AWS management console. This video session is intended to help you launch your first instance quickly, so it doesn't cover all possible options. First, you need to log in the AWS management console using your credentials. Then on the services menu, click EC2. It is a EC2 dashboard console. In the dashboard console, just click launch instance. In the choose on Amazon image page, you need to select the Amazon Linux AMI. Usually the first choice in the list, click select for this AMI. In the choose on instance type page, you need to select general purpose T2 micro. It is for free tier eligible. Then click next configure instance details. In the configure instance detail page, you can find out network settings, then availability zone, where you would set access, then the monitoring, then other options also you can see here. Then leave the default option selected and click next hard storage. In the hard storage page, just leave the default option and click next hard tag. In the hard tag page, just click hard tag. In the key value box, just click a name. Here value, just need to click the, just need to like put the your system name. Just I given a free cloud one. Then click next configure security group. In the configure security group page, you need to select a create a security group. In the security group name box, you need to give your security group name. I'm giving Jaypree Cloud 2. Description, if you want, you can put your identity. Here you can leave the default security group as it allows port 22. Then like a type SSH. Then here source, you have to select anywhere option. Then click review and launch. Then click launch. Here you need to select create new key pair. Then here you need to click the, you need to like give the key pair name. I'm giving Jaypree Cloud 2. Once you given, just you need to click the download key pair, otherwise it will not enable the launch instance. Just you need to click the download key pair, then click save. After that, click launch. Now instance is launching. You need to select view instance. See, now instance is creating. Meanwhile, we can like convert the PPK file from .pem file. Just you need to open the putty key generator, then click load, then click all files in the file name category. After that, click your file name Jaypree Cloud. This is the .pem file, and click open. Then it will like, you know, successfully imported a foreign key using the open SSH SSH2 private key. Just you can click OK. After that, click save private key. Then click yes. Then give the type of Jaypree Cloud in the file name. Here this is our file. Then remove the .pem. Then click save. Then you can confirm the file name here. This is our Jaypree Cloud. 2.ppk file. Now your user instance is created, but it is checking the status. Here if you go the like a status check, see here two status checks are there. One is a system status check, another one is instance status checks. Once this completed, then automatically it will modify the 2/2 checks. Okay, just so you can click the descriptions and select your user instance and copy your public DNS name and open the putty and copy your public DNS name in the hostname or IP address box. Okay, in the appearance, just you can click the change and click bold. Just I'm like changing the font and font style and size for your appearance purpose, and expand the SSH and click auth, then click browser and click your ppk file, then click open, click yes, then click the ec2-user. This is then give the ec2-user. It is your username. Now we are able to connect the our Linux machine in the putty session. Just you can check the free-m here. This is our RAM size, then click CPU, sorry, then click top, sorry, then type top, then click enter, then press the number 1. It will show the CPU details here. CPU 0, it means we have only one CPU in this machine. Now see, here it is changed to 2/2 checks. It means our user instance ready to access. Now I'm going to terminate this user instance. Just you need to select your user instance and click actions and click instance state, then click terminate, then click yes terminate. Now our user instance is going to terminate. Once terminated, you can sign out your accounts. Thanks for watching this video. If you like, please subscribe. Also refer your friends.